Monday morning, February 13th, 2023, and it's about noon. It's about 12 o'clock noon Pacific time. Hope you're doing well. Lord, I just thank you for this time together in your word for however long. I really would like to just kind of relax and share and who knows what. But Lord, Psalm 61, we send your word out, Lord, to help people everywhere, especially where they're hurting so bad. Ohio, where that train derailment and catastrophe. Lord, help the people, help the environment. Help maybe somebody from the Biden administration speak about it. And Lord, we lift up the situation with the balloons, the unidentified flying objects. We bind you, Satan, in the name of Jesus Christ, from our lives, from our country, from our world, from our personal lives, in Jesus' name. We lift up people that had to get up and go to work this morning. And Lord, we thank you for the privilege of being able to work and make money and pay the bills. But it's not easy, Lord, for people. We pray for you to give them an extra amount of grace every morning and every day, a power, and that you supply every need, Lord, to pay the bills. We thank you for your mercy and your grace. We thank you, God Almighty, for your promises and for who you are in our lives. There is a distinction. There is a distinction, and we receive what belongs to us in Christ Jesus, inheritance in Christ Jesus that belongs to us as believers. And Lord, that you would glorify yourself in and through us and help the world believe you are who you say you are, Jesus, the Son of the living God. Psalm 61, hear my cry, O God, attend unto my prayer. From the end of the earth will I cry unto thee when my heart is overwhelmed. Lead me to the rock that is higher than I. For thou hast been a shelter for me and a strong tower from the enemy. I will abide in thy tabernacle forever. I will trust in the covert of thy wings, Selah. For thou, O God, hast heard my vows. Thou hast given me the heritage of those that fear thy name. Praise you, Lord, for your church, the body of Christ, the people of God, Lord. Thou wilt prolong the king's life and his years as many generations. He shall abide before God forever. O prepare mercy and truth which may preserve him. So will I sing praise unto thy name forever, that I may daily perform my vows. We thank you for your word, Lord. Now, Lord, we thank you also for the Gospels, Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. And here's just a little bit of Matthew 13. The same day went Jesus out of the house and sat by the seaside, and great multitudes were gathered together unto him, so that he went into a ship and sat, and the whole multitude stood on the shore. And he spake many things unto them in parables, saying, Behold, a sower went forth to sow. And when he sowed, some seeds fell by the wayside, and the fowls came and devoured them up. Some fell upon stony places, for they had not much earth, and forthwith they sprung up, because they had no deepness of earth. And when the sun was up, they were scorched, and because they had no root, they withered away. And some fell among thorns, and the thorns sprung up and choked them. But other fell on good ground, and brought forth fruit, some 100-fold, some 60-fold, some 30-fold. Who hath ears to hear, let him hear. Now, you can read the rest of this chapter, Matthew 13, And then just keep reading if you want. In Jesus' name. Galatians. Let me see. Galatians. We'll just skip around maybe on this, okay? Galatians 1. Paul, an apostle, not of men, neither by man, but by Jesus Christ and God the Father, who raised him from the dead, and all the brethren which are with me unto the churches of Galatia. Grace be to you and peace from God our Father and from the Lord Jesus Christ. We send your word out, Lord. We send grace and peace out into your people, into our country, into the world, Lord. Grace and peace and safety. We come against this war in Ukraine from Putin. We bind it in the name of Jesus. We bind you, demons from hell. We bind you. Back up, back off. Leave him alone, leave him alone, leave him alone. Stop it. In the name of Jesus Christ. High electric bills, high gas bills, we bind you. We bind you. Wherever you're coming from, we bind you. Whatever excuse you're making, we bind you. Stop it. Stop it. Whatever the excuse is from the Biden administration for not figuring things out, for not keeping our country safe from being invaded, stop it. It's incompetence. Trump would not let this happen. Okay? He would say, whatever it took, he would say, find somebody to fix this and fix it. Okay? You are incompetent. You must be just incompetent. You don't even know, you know, in your White House press briefing, the guy up there didn't even know what he was talking about. Okay, so God give you grace. God give us all grace. You know, that's not what the deep state is doing to those that they are persecuting. Like the father of the children that he went to the school and the daughter had been being abused. And they went and arrested him. Be careful, deep state, who you are abusing. Be careful, people, who you are abusing. You have been abusing President Trump for how many years now? Looking for a crime. Looking for a crime. Not giving him grace, like, oh, he was a great businessman and he helped his employees with the guy that you threw in prison a few weeks ago. That poor man worked his ass off his whole life and you put him in prison because President Trump helped him. I don't know what he did. I don't know the details. But did you go and you look, you know, with your little magnifying glass in all the other business people and what they've done for their employees? Did you take your magnifying glass and look for the crimes? Why don't you go look for real criminals and real crime? I pray for you to stop it. And that God Almighty would straighten you out and that you would go out and get the real criminals. Okay? And I know that you're doing a great job in areas of life, in some areas of life, but you got off onto politics. And because you didn't like President Trump and the Democrats hated him and the Trump-hating GOP hated him, you went after him. And you're continuing to go after him, Letitia James, in the state of New York. You know, he built beautiful hotels, beautiful Trump Tower, and did a lot of good for that city. And what did you do? You've gone in there to tear his soul down. You people tear the soul down of people. You're sick. You're demented. You're evil. You let the devil work through you. You let the devil work through you, and you do his work. You do his bidding. That's evil, and God will hold you accountable. It might not happen right away. You better get the fear of God in your life. You better get the fear of God in your life. It is seeped out into the streets. You know, because you take things too far. And then the people on the street think they can get away with crime because you get away with crime. I'm sorry. I didn't plan for this morning. But it needs to stop. We need to come into a period where we can rest a little bit. Get back to normal, whatever that is. I know these are the last days, maybe. I think it's going to always be the last days. So Jesus, come quickly. Help the people cross from unbelief into faith and get in the kingdom of God quickly. Because you don't know the day or the hour. We don't know the day or the hour. But you think those people in Turkey that had that great earthquake come and destroy thousands of people, over 20,000 people now? You know? We need to make sure that we're in the kingdom of God, okay? And then also give some money into those people that are preaching the gospel. I'm not asking you for money from me. I'm saying consider. Start with $5. Start with $2. Start with $10. Start with a tithe, 10%. Into places, churches, pastors, where they are preaching the gospel of Jesus Christ. Because we operate in a different financial world. We operate in the kingdom of God, and His kingdom is not of this world. So when you give into the gospel, when you give at church where they're preaching the gospel, you have your money tied into the kingdom of God, and God is able to bless you, take care of you in a better way. And you know, for people that aren't doing that, God gives you grace. But when you can come around to it, I'm not perfect at it. I'll tell you that, I'm not perfect at it. To the letter of the T, dot the I, and cross the T on things. So Lord, thank you for your word. Thank you for cleansing us with your word. Grace be to you, verse 3, Galatians 1, 3. Grace be to you and peace from God the Father and from our Lord Jesus Christ, who gave himself for our sins, that he might deliver us from this present evil world, according to the will of God and our Father, to whom be glory forever and ever. Amen. Lord, put your arms around us, Lord. Put your arms around us. Hurting marriages, hurting children, hurting families, homeless. Lord, have mercy. Businesses, help them, Lord. Big and little businesses, help everybody. Make the ends meet. Make ends meet in a greater way than even imaginable, Lord. You're able to do above all that we ask or think according to the power that worketh in us. So thank you, Lord. Protect our country. Give our leaders wisdom. Touch the churches. Help them be prepared. They already are now. You've dug up the fallow ground, Lord. So help us all be, and we will be, all be ready when you fill the churches and you bring peace to the land and you prepare us for your coming. You prepare us to take us out of here on that day and that hour, that minute. Until then, we will occupy. Until you come, we will be about our Father's business, whatever it is, small or large. Help us not lean to our own understanding. Touch the children, bless the children, protect, online and offline, the children. Help them, give them discernment what to watch on YouTube, what to change to. Just change it. If it's bad, if it's evil, if it's violent, change it. Help them just change it, Lord. We lift up the children. We pray for our supernatural anointing upon the children. To not watch bad things on YouTube. To not watch bad things on videos. Bless them in school, Lord. Bless the homeschoolers. Bless the schools. Bless and touch the teachers, Lord. help the children get along. We bind shootings. We bind violence at schools. We continue to take authority over violence and shootings. In Jesus Christ's holy name, we're tired of the crises. We're tired of the crises that the devil instigates through people. So we thank you for your peace, Lord. Peace, 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 Lord. And you know, your word says when they see peace, peace, then you know destruction will come. So thank you for your grace and your mercy, Lord, upon this world. In Jesus' name, amen. Thanks for watching. God bless. Have a great day and have some fun. In Jesus' name, amen.